In this closer look, you're going to learn how to diagram Lewis structures. Lewis structures, sometimes also called Lewis dot diagrams, are models that represent the bonds between atoms in a molecule, and also the lone pairs of electrons, which are additional electrons that are not part of a bond. When considering atomic bonds, always keep the octet rule in mind, which states that most atoms will tend to form bonds that result in 8 valence electrons, which form the most stable compounds. However, there are exceptions to the octet rule. Groups 1, 2, and 3 of the periodic table have, respectively, elements that can have 2, 4, and 6 valence electrons when they bond and still be stable. Group 1 contains the most notable exception to the octet rule, hydrogen, which is so small it can be stable with only 2 valence electrons. In group 2, an example is beryllium. When it forms covalent compounds, it would have only 4 valence electrons around it, but it would still be stable. A group 3 exception would be boron, which can have 6 valence electrons around it and still be stable. There is another exception that is occasionally found in larger elements. These elements can form what is known as an expanded octet, in which there is a central atom with more than 8 valence electrons around it. Now, let's go over the basic steps for creating Lewis structures, and then look at examples using several types of molecules. Here are the steps. First, find the total number of valence electrons in the molecule by adding up the valence electrons for each element that make up the molecule. Then arrange the atoms symmetrically with the least electronegative element in the middle. Next, draw lines between the atoms, which represent single bonds. Each line stands for the 2 electrons that are shared between the 2 atoms. Then, draw the remaining electrons, the lone pairs, as dots around the outer atoms, and if needed, around the central atom. When constructing Lewis structures, remember the exceptions and always take those into account. If there aren't enough electrons to satisfy the octet rule, start over and draw lines that will represent double or triple bonds that will resolve the problem. Keep in mind you have to find a home for all of the electrons that were tallied in your initial electron count of the molecule. Ready to see how it works? Let's draw a Lewis structure for carbon tetrafluoride, CF4. First, tally the valence electrons. There is one carbon in this molecule, which contributes 4 valence electrons. There are 4 fluorines, which are in group 7, so they have 7 valence electrons each for a total of 28. So add the 4 from the carbon and the 28 from the fluorines for a total of 32. That's how many electrons you have to place in the Lewis structure for carbon tetrafluoride. Carbon, the least electronegative of the atoms, is central. Arrange the other atoms in the molecule symmetrically around it. Now, start placing single bonds. So there are 2, 4, 6, 8 electrons so far. Now, 8 of the 32 electrons have been placed. So there are 24 more that still need to be placed. So start placing lone pairs of electrons, shown as these dots, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24. Those 24 electrons, added to the 8 from the single bonds, equals 32, the same number as the original tally of valence electrons. So all 32 electrons that were there to begin with have been placed. And to make sure your Lewis structure is correct, always check to make sure that each atom is stable. So this fluorine has 8, this fluorine has 8, this fluorine has 8, and this fluorine has 8. And even the central carbon has 8, because remember, a line indicates a shared pair of electrons, or a single bond. Now let's try NH3, which is ammonia. First, tally the electrons. Nitrogen is in group 5, so it has 5 valence electrons. There are 3 hydrogen atoms, which are in group 1, and each hydrogen brings 1 valence electron with it. The total is the 5 valence electrons from the nitrogen, plus the 3 valence electrons contributed from the 3 hydrogens, and so there are 8 valence electrons to place in a Lewis structure of an NH3 molecule. Next, start arranging the atoms. Remember, hydrogen cannot be central because it can only have 2 electrons around it. The nitrogen atom must be central then. Now arrange the rest of the atoms symmetrically. Start drawing single bonds first. Each one of these represents 2 electrons, so that's 2, 4, 6 electrons that have been placed. Then place a lone pair here on the nitrogen, because there are 8 electrons to place, and without that lone pair on nitrogen, there would only be 6 electrons around it. So hydrogen claims 2 valence electrons, and remember, it is an exception to the octet rule, and it is stable. The nitrogen has 2, 4, 6, 8 electrons around it, so it is also stable. That's a complete Lewis structure for NH3. Next, let's construct the Lewis structure for water. Do the electron tally first. There are 2 hydrogens, so that's 2 valence electrons. There is 1 oxygen, which is in group 6, so that's 6 valence electrons. So again, there are a total of 8 valence electrons to place. Remember, hydrogen cannot be central. So arrange the atoms like this, with oxygen central. Draw single bonds first, and each one represents a shared pair, so that's 2 electrons, and that's 4 electrons. Now place the lone pairs, 6, 8, and that equals the original total of 8 electrons. Always check to make sure that each element in the structure is stable. Hydrogen only needs 2 electrons around it to be stable. And there's the 2 it can claim, so it's stable. And this hydrogen gets to claim those 2 electrons, so it is also stable. Oxygen has 2, 4, 6, 8 electrons around it, and so it is stable too. And all 8 electrons that were tallied at the beginning have been placed, completing the Lewis structure. Now let's do a Lewis structure for carbon dioxide, CO2. One carbon will contribute 4 valence electrons. And there are 2 oxygens in this molecule, and oxygen is in group 6, so each one has 6 valence electrons. And 2 times 6 is 12, so the 2 oxygens contribute 12 valence electrons. The total is 16 valence electrons that need to be placed in the Lewis structure. Place the least electronegative element in the middle, that's carbon, and arrange the oxygens this way, symmetrically, and do single bonds first. So that's 2, 4, then place the lone pairs on the outside of the outer oxygens. So that will be 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16. This is not a finished Lewis structure because notice that carbon is not stable. It only has 2, 4 electrons around it. So this is the first time that the rule in the steps covered earlier about using double or triple bonds to satisfy the octet rule will be needed. In this structure for CO2, there are no more electrons, and carbon isn't stable, so you have to start over. And remember, there are 16 electrons to place, so you can try using multiple bonds and see what happens. Sometimes Lewis structures require trial and error, and this is where double and triple bonds can come into play. Using a double bond like this, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, is exactly what is needed. Carbon has 2, 4, 6, 8 electrons, therefore making it stable. And this oxygen, it has 2, 4, 6, 8. And this oxygen has 2, 4, 6, 8. And there are 16 electrons placed in our Lewis structure, the total from the initial tally. Now, let's try Lewis structure for the nitrogen molecule. Obviously, there are only 2 nitrogen atoms in the molecule, which are in group 5, with 5 valence electrons to contribute, So there are 10 electrons to be placed in this structure. Both nitrogen atoms must satisfy the octet rule. If you draw a single bond here, and then try to assign lone pairs on the nitrogens, you will find that there are not enough electrons to satisfy the octet rule for both nitrogen atoms. See? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. This is not a stable Lewis representation, so it needs another try. Go back and use a double bond. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. But you still run out of electrons before both nitrogen atoms are stable. So this time, try a triple bond. Draw three lines, which represent 2, 4, 6 electrons. That's a triple bond. Then put one lone pair on each nitrogen. Now, notice that each nitrogen gets to claim these 6 electrons. And there's a lone pair here, so that gives 8 electrons around this nitrogen. And this lone pair gives 8 electrons around this nitrogen. And this Lewis structure now satisfies the octet rule. We've looked at several examples of Lewis structures of molecules. When constructing a Lewis structure for a polyatomic ion, the rules are essentially the same, except under two conditions. If it's a polyatomic anion, or it's negatively charged, add one electron to the total for each negative charge. If it's a cation, like ammonium, subtract an electron for each positive charge. In each of these cases, when you finish the Lewis structure, place it in brackets and put the charge of the ion in the upper right-hand corner. Let's look at some of these polyatomic ions. The first example is ammonium, NH4+. There is one nitrogen, and nitrogen is in group 5, so it contributes 5 valence electrons. There are 4 hydrogens, and each hydrogen contributes 1 electron, so that's a total of 4 electrons for an overall total of 9. However, notice this charge of plus 1. So because of that, you must subtract 1 electron from the total, down here, and it brings the total to 8 valence electrons. As you construct this, you still want to put the nitrogen central and arrange the other elements in a symmetrical fashion. Then start placing the single bonds, 2, 4, 6, 8. Now you've placed the total of 8 electrons. And now put the whole Lewis structure in brackets and then indicate the charge of plus 1 in the upper right-hand corner. So that's how to construct the Lewis structure for ammonium, the polyatomic ion. Now let's see if you're ready to try one on your own. Here's the polyatomic ion perchlorate, ClO4-1-. Take a look and then pause the video and draw a Lewis structure. When you're ready, come back, hit play, and check your answer. This is the completed Lewis structure. Let's see how close you got. The chlorine is in group 7, so it has 7 valence electrons. Oxygen is in group 6, and there are 4 of them in the perchlorate ion. So that adds up to 24 valence electrons. Then add these two together, the 24 and the 7, adding up to 31, but take into account this 1-negative charge. Since this is 1-negative, we must add that 1 electron to the total. So that gives 32 electrons to be placed. The chlorine is central, so it goes here. Then arrange the oxygens around the outside and start drawing single bonds from chlorine to the oxygen. Next, add the lone pairs on the outside atoms and count them. Notice each element has 8 electrons around it. 8 around this oxygen, 8 around this one, 8 around this oxygen, 8 around this one too, and this chlorine gets to claim 8 as well. Since it's a polyatomic, put the entire structure in brackets and then place a charge of 1-negative in the upper right-hand corner. And here's one more for you to try. Go ahead and pause the video and see if you can come up with the structure for phosphorus trichloride, PCl3. This is your completed Lewis structure for phosphorus trichloride. Did you get close? Phosphorus is in group 5, so it has 5 valence electrons that it contributes to the total. Chlorine is in group 7, and there are 3 of them, so it contributes 21 valence electrons. The total number of electrons that you have to place is 26. Put phosphorus central when you set up the structure. The chlorines go on the outside. Start off with single bonds, so that's 2, 4, 6, and then it's time to assign the lone pairs, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, and those 20 electrons with the 6 electrons already bound add up to 26. And each atom is satisfied in terms of the octet rule, and that's a stable, correct Lewis structure. And that's a closer look at Lewis structures. For more chemistry matters, go to the homepage where the entire series is available to you.